Spider-Man Miles Morales has finally made its way over to PC, and after the excellent port of Spider-Man Remastered last month, Nexis is trying to build on all the great work they did before and deliver another excellent port. And since both Spider-Man Remastered and Miles Morales share the same engine and technology, the graphic settings between the two games are identical, with the addition of ray traced shadows for Miles Morales. And today, as usual, we will take a look at each setting and see how it affects both visuals and performance. So without any further ado, let's get going. Kicking off with anti-aliasing and comparing off SMAA and GAA here, as expected, GAA provide the best image quality. Performance-wise, off and SMAA are similar, and GAA drop FPS by 3%. And if we compare DLAA with GAA, we can see that DLAA cleaned the image entirely with minimal impact to performance on the 3060 Ti. Here, of course, I recommend GAA. And if the performance hit of DLAA on your GPU is negligible, use it. Next, we have texture quality. This one is straightforward. Higher options provide higher resolution and more detailed textures, and it mostly affects the VRAM usage. I did this test at 1440p, and you can see that even with very high textures, VRAM usage is still below 8GB. So here I don't really have any recommendation. It depends on your GPU, resolution, and other settings that can impact the VRAM, like ray tracing. Texture filtering usually don't impact the performance, and here in Miles Morales, that's not entirely true, because going from trilinear to 2x, drop FPS by 1%, to 4x by 2.5%, 8x around 5%, and to 16x by 8%. Normally, I would recommend 16x, but here I think 8x is the best option. And shadow quality, when it comes to short distance shadows, options from medium to very high look so similar, but the difference appears when looking at long distance shadows, like here. Performance wise, going from very low to low, drop FPS by 1%, to medium around 2.5%, high 4%, and to very high 7%. Here, in my opinion, medium or high are the best options. If you remember in Spider-Man Remastered, the game launched with a problem in HBAO+. Now in Miles Morales, HBAO+ is improved and looks much better in some areas like here. But on other areas like this one, this option still failed to cover some surfaces. Performance-wise, going from off to SSAO drop FPS by 4% and to HBAO+ around 8%. Even after all the improvement to HBAO+ and Spider-Man's Remastered updates and Miles Morales, it's still not enough. That's why sticking to SSAO is recommended for the best look and performance. Screen space reflection comes with a toggle, on or off. Enabling SSR drop FPS by 6%. Here I recommend keeping SSR on because it adds a lot to the game visuals and presentation. Miles Morales comes with two forms of RT. One of them is RT reflection, and similar to Spider-Man Remastered, we have an option to control the resolution of reflections, like here, where going from high to very high make these trees look more detailed due to the higher resolution reflection, but that drop FPS by a huge 30% with the RTX 3060 Ti at 1440p. Here I think high is the best option. The second option is reflection geometry detail, which controls the quality of buildings and other objects and reflections. Performance-wise, going from high to very high drop FPS by around 11%. Here I recommend high. And last, we have object range, to control the range at which objects are considered as reflections. In other words, the higher the slider, the more objects we get in reflections. Now when GPU bound like here, going from 0 to 5 drop FPS by 8% and to 10 around 13%. But when CPU bound, going from 0 to 5 drop FPS by 9%, but to 10 a big 20%. Here it really depends on your CPU. You should experiment with each number and see which one gives you the best performance. The second form of Archie and Miles Morales is ray traced shadows, which is a mixed bag. On one hand, it offers great improvement as it adds more accurate and realistic shadows, and it can capture and add shadows for small objects like here with foliage or these pipes. But on the other hand, in some situations, it can look worse than normal shadows, like here with this flag, where you can see that Archie's shadow looks static and doesn't animate like normal ones. And other problems with tree shadows. And the biggest problem, in my opinion, is how heavy it is. Because just enabling Archie shadows, even at medium, drop FPS by 27%, going to high 32%, and to very high 42% on the 3060 Ti. Here, because of all the issues and the high cost of Archie shadow, I don't recommend using it. At level of detail, higher options draw more objects in the distance, as you can see here. And also using lower option makes some animated signs in the distance like here look static. Now performance wise, going from very low to low and medium, drop FPS by 2.5% to high 4% and to very high 5%. Here I recommend high. Another setting that wasn't working properly in Spider-Man Remastered is traffic density. And unfortunately it's similar story here in Miles Morales, where all the options looks like a different formation of each other, and also the performance is similar between the four options. Here I'll go for very low. Crowd density also had some problems before in Spider-Man Remastered, but here in Miles Morales it seems like they improve it. As you can see here, when GPU bound, the difference between the four options is minimal. Because going from very low to high, drop FPS by 3%. But when CPU bound, the difference increased to 7%. So here it depends on your CPU. Personally, I'll go for very low because it still looks fine and populated and doesn't turn the city into an empty ghost town. Hair quality in Spider-Man Remastered was demanding when using high. Here in Miles, high is even more demanding because it looks a lot better compared to other options. Very low, low and medium perform similarly, but going to high drop FPS by a whopping 22% at this scene here. Medium is the best option in my opinion. Yes, high looks great, but 22% is just too much. Now one setting that affects the visuals differently in Miles Morales compared to Spider-Man Remastered is weather particle quality. If you recall, in Spider-Man Remastered, this one was one of the most demanding settings because it adds volumetric clouds when using the higher options. Here in Miles Morales, it doesn't add volumetric clouds, but instead it affects the density of particles like snow, as you can see here. And during the day, it can add this subtle blue haze like here. Performance wise, going from low to medium, drop FPS by 3% and 4% to high and very high. Here I think low or medium are the best options because during normal gameplay, the difference between low and even high is not distinguishable. And finally, we have depth of field. You'll see this one mostly on cutscenes like here, where going from off to the ugly very low doesn't affect performance that much, and similar story to the other options. Here if you like this effect, avoid using very low. Now based on what we've seen so far, these are my recommended settings. Now let's do a comparison between these settings and very high preset with Archie shadows off. As you can see, using the recommended settings should give you around 50% boost with minimal impact to the visuals. Now to wrap this up, Spider-Man Miles Morales on PC is an excellent port and Nexus did a great job. But there are still some problems with HBO Plus, traffic density, and the biggest one is Archie shadows, which looks like it needs a lot of additional polish to work well on the game engine. When it comes to tweaking settings, hair quality and ray tracing, with all its forms and options, are the most demanding settings. And with that, we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for any future videos, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.